In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of erector spinae. Erector spinae. This is on back side of body. I think this is the most famous back muscle. I am going to explain its origin, insertion, and function. There are three muscles in erector spinae. The outermost part is iliocostalis. Middle fiber is longissimus. And most medial part is spinalis. The outermost part is iliocostalis. Middle one is longissimus. The most medial part is spinalis. So here is how you remember. From outside, that's I, L, S, right? So this is I love spaghetti or I love spinach, however you want to remember, okay? Iliocostalis, longissimus, spinalis. Now, there are different fibers in iliocostalis, longissimus, and spinalis. So, let me explain detail of each fibers. First one is iliocostalis. There are three fibers in iliocostalis. First one is iliocostalis lamborum. Its origin is very wide. It originates from sacrum, here, iliac crest. And this white part, this is thoracolumbar fascia. That's it. It's very, very wide. It's sacrum, iliac crest, and thoracolumbar fascia. This is origin. Insertion is also wide. It attaches to rib 6 through 12. So it's like this area. Plus thoracolumbar fascia again. Thoracolumbar fascia. It's very, very wide muscle. This is iliocostalis lamborum. So let's move on to next fiber. Next one is iliocostalis thoracis. Its origin is rib 7 through 12. It's about this area. Insertion is rib 1 through 6. It's like this area. So this is iliocostalis thoracis. Simple, right? Last one is iliocostalis cervicis. Its origin is rib 3 through 7. So it's like here. Insertion is C4 through 6. About this area. So these three fibers are in iliocostalis. Iliocostalis lamborum, thoracis, and cervicis. This is iliocostalis. So let's move on to longissimus. Next one is longissimus. There are also three fibers in longissimus. First one is longissimus thoracis. Its origin is similar to iliocostalis lamborum. This fiber originates from sacrum, here, and iliac crest, and transverse processes of lumbar spines. Transverse processes. These are origin. Let's go to insertion. Insertion is rib 2 through 12. Oh my gosh, it's very, very long. It's about this area. And lumbar spines and thoracic spines. That's natural, right? So let's say lumbar and thoracic spines. That's it. This is longissimus thoracis. There are two other fibers. Next one is longissimus cervicis. Its origin is T1 through 6. T1 through 6. So it's like this area. Insertion is C2 through C5. So C2 through 5 is like here. Okay, this is longissimus cervicis. Last one is longissimus capitis. Longissimus capitis. Origin is T1 through 7. So T1 through 7, it's like here. Insertion is mastoid process. Mastoid process is on head, right? That is why this muscle is longissimus capitis. Capitis means head, because this muscle attaches to head, which is mastoid process. Okay, this is longissimus. It has three fibers. Longissimus thoracis, cervicis, and capitis. Next one is last one. Let me explain spinalis. Okay, next one is spinalis. There are two fibers, spinalis thoracis. Okay, origin of spinalis thoracis is T10 through L3. It's very wide range, T3 through L3, about here. This is origin. Insertion is T2 through 8. T2 through 8, so it's like this area, okay? This is spinalis thoracis. One more fiber, spinalis cervicis. Origin is C5 through T2. So C5 through T2, it's like this area. Insertion is C2 through C4. You don't see that, but C2 is here and C4 is about here. That's it. Spinalis. Two fibers. Spinalis thoracis and spinalis cervicis. I quote these numbers from anatomy book. However, you don't have to remember every single detail of numbers. Most important thing is there are three fibers in erector spinae. That's it. From outside, it's iliocostalis, longissimus, and spinalis. You just remember general location of these fibers. Okay, it's simple, right? Now let me explain its function. Okay, function of each fiber is common. Let's say there are erector spinae on left side. What happens when both sides contract? That does extension. Extension of spines. This is the strongest function in erector spinae. Erector spinae that erect spines. That is extension. Simple. What happens when one side contracts? That brings trunk to sidebend. Sidebend. Simple, right? This is also from anatomy book. This is my hypothesis from now on. Okay? Direction of fiber of this muscle is slightly diagonal. It is not completely vertical. It's not. It's diagonal. So when muscle pulls trunk this way, I suspect this muscle can do rotation for same direction. That is ipsilateral rotation. Ipsilateral rotations. But this is not on major anatomy books. So let's say this is question. This is just my hypothesis. Main function is extension and side bend. But if you look carefully at direction, maybe it can do ipsilateral rotation. Same side rotation. Okay. In this video, I explained basic anatomy of erector spinae. I said there are three fibers in erector spinae. Iliocostalis, longissimus, and spinalis. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.